Mauricio, I talked to Tim Bradley. He told me he did 200 rounds with you, and out of everyone he's ever sparred, you're the hardest guy to hit. He said you can't hit you. Why does he say that?
You better believe this.
Yeah, we've been sparring Bradley for a while.
200 rounds, he said.
Yeah, a lot of sparring. But I don't like to be hit. What can I say?
But how do you do it? Like, how do you stand in front of someone and not let them touch you?
Well, I know you're familiar with James Toney.
Of course.
He doesn't get hit.
I sparred him. He beat me up like a pinata.
Yeah, there you go. I will beat you like a pinata too. No, James Toney is an art. Defense is great. Slick. He can stay right there. You can't hit him. I was fighting that way until I saw him. So I saw he does way better. And started learning from him. So I watch a lot of videos of Toney, James Toney. And it's always defense first. My first trainer always taught me. Defense is the first thing I learned. Anybody can throw.
You fought Ruslan and beat him. He just fought Castillo. Would you want to fight him again?
Yeah, why not? I'll fight Castillo. Or Ruslan.
What did he say?
I'll fight Castillo. No, I'll fight Ruslan. It's a tough fight. I think he's the most dangerous at 140.
What about Danny? Would you want a rematch with that? Danny Garcia?
Soccer.
Oh, no, not soccer.
Look, Ruslan is tough. Tougher than Danny. I'll take both. But yeah, it's up to Danny. Danny's the true champion. He'll give me a rematch. I mean, the fans saw it. It was close. Or I won it. He doesn't want to believe that. A true champion always gives rematches. Go way back. Everybody gives them rematches.
John Molina Jr., I just spoke to him yesterday. He's a big supporter of yours. He knows you. He's in 140 now, too.
Oh, is he? He's big 140.
That division's getting hot. Yeah. It has always been popular.
Nowhere to run. 140, 147. You got to stick it out. We both are tough, so it doesn't matter where you go. You're going to find a good fight.
Last thing, if you had your choice, would you want Adrian Broner or would you want, let's see, who just fought this weekend on HBO? Thomas DeLorme.
Thomas DeLorme? Or Adrian Broner?
Either one?
Everybody likes Adrian Broner. They want to see him get beat up again. And why not? Adrian Broner.
What's your prediction if that fight happens?
Me winning. Sticking the jab. Nobody knows what to do. It's the oldest thing in the book. And nobody knows how to throw it or get away from me.
So last thing, Mauricio, introduce your team here. Who's here with you today?
This is Willie Silva, my manager. This is my dad, Mauricio Herrera. This is Jose Torres on the phone all the time.
Jose's very humble. He's very low-key.
Humble guy, yeah.
Yeah.
This is Albert, my brother.
Hey, what's up? Does he box too?
Yeah, he boxes too. He's a pro.
Yeah, he's a fighter.
You guys remember seeing under when I fought Ruslan Provagno, he was a co-main event with Andrade. He's now a world champion. So he's been right behind me.
Oh, I forgot the last thing. What did you think of Pacquiao Algieri fight?
Pacquiao Algieri, I was happy. I'm glad Algieri got put in his place. Because, I don't know, just something about him, I didn't like him. Just like Freddie Rhodes. I don't know. He was a little too cocky. I don't know if it was just the way he sounded. And plus, I know I'm a little butthurt that I fought Ruslan and beat him. And he beats Ruslan, and I beat him worse. And he gets over $1 million payday with Pacquiao.
Yeah,
and now he's all famous.
Yeah,
I didn't even get that shot. I'm still fighting my way to the top. Tough guys that nobody is even noticing.
Yeah.
But I'll come up. I mean, they spill big spotlights, so hopefully they'll recognize me a little more.
Nobody want to fight him. That's the truth. Nobody want to fight him.
There you have it. Mauricio Herrera, FuseSports.com, and Melissa back reporting.